it's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey.
Welcome back to Marbella Now. My name is Nicole King, and this week we're starting off our program from La Colonia Shopping Center here in San Pedro de Alcantara. This place is home to McDonald's, the Passion Cafe, lots of great boutiques for us ladies. Also, there's a decoration shop for homes, you've got a supermarket, there are shops for golfers, but it's also home to Talk Radio Europe, and that's where we're going to start off this week's show.
It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey.
What better person to talk to first here at Talk Radio Europe than Stephanie Miller? She's the executive producer, head of public relations. But to most people, this great title is actually more just Steph. Hi, Steph.
Good morning, Nicole.
It's lovely to have the opportunity to chat with you here in your own home. You've been to Marbella Now before, talking about the great projects and charity events you do. But before we talk about that, Steph, a little bit about you. Where are you from? How did you get to Marbella?
Oh, gosh, 1988. I moved here with my husband, three small children. They've grown up here. They've been to school here. They've now raising their own families. They've got married here. Husband's left. So it's me.
Just you, yeah, with your wonderful family. Yeah. Do you speak Spanish? You integrated with the Spanish community?
Yeah, my kids have integrated more, I think, because they went to school. They went to Spanish school. One of them's married to a Spaniard, so I have Spanish grandchildren. And, yeah, we've integrated fine.
It's lovely to see that there are a lot of people who don't integrate. They come here because there's a big English community. Yeah. Talk Radio Europe must be a big part of a lot of people's lives. You cover all the coasts along all, you know, with your English language programming.
We do, actually. And we, as I say, you know, we are the lifeline of a lot of people that live out here. And we broadcast from Gibraltar all the way along the Costa del Sol, up the east coast of Spain, into Mallorca or onto Mallorca and Ibiza as well. So it's a lot of people, and we also have a lot of listeners online.
It's wonderful because it really is a communication. People are talking, but it's a both-way conversation.
Well, we are. We're talk radio. We do more talk than music. We do a lot of interviews, and that's where my job comes in, finding what's in the news, new autobiographies, whatever. Whatever makes interesting listening, we have to find the interviews. Most of them are done over the phone or via Skype or whichever way we can do them. But sometimes we have guests coming in. And yeah, that's how we work. It's a lot of work.
It is a lot of work and a lot of different programs. Yes. It's a local type of station, but at the same time, you cover everything internationally. But the variety goes from the breakfast show, you have Pippa Jones with a really serious political issues.
And we have the mid-morning show, which is presented by Bill Padley. That's my main area of focus where production goes. Yes, I help out with a lot of the other programs, but my main one is the mid-morning show. And there we cover also a lot, and we have a travel show, and we have our lifestyle show in the afternoon with Selena McKenzie, and then we have the drive time show with Dave Hodgson, and each program is geared for the type of listener, the time of day. And as you said, we have Pippa also, who is far more political.
And Giles Brown, who's on the show now with his own particular twist on everything that goes on in Marbella.
Exactly. Giles now presents Viewpoint, which is our debate program. And we usually have two or three guests live in the studio with him. And the phone lines are open for listeners to call in and give their opinion on what's happening around the world and what's in the news.
Yeah, well, I'm a big listener of Talk Radio Europe, I have to say. And someone we're going to be chatting with a bit later, Pancho, also has a wine program. So you really do cover it all.
We do. Pancho comes on every Wednesday at about 11:30, have a chat with Bill about what's new in wine. And he also has his own program once a week, but he's on sort of sabbatical until October. Everybody breaks for the summer.
And it's nice, actually. And the thing is, the nice about the Marbella community is it is a community, because Pancho is actually the other half of Melissa Butler, who we met last week at the American College of Spain. And we're going along there, actually, later on this morning. So, Stephanie, is there a big team of you here all the time in the studios?
It depends. It depends who's on air. At the moment, we've got a couple of people in the sales department. We have two main production, myself and Wendy. And then in the other room, you'll see Hannah preparing for her show, Selena preparing for her show. And
well, we're definitely, if you let it, is going to go in and meet them. But before we do, you do a telethon for Cudeca. Tell us quickly about that. I know it's not coming up just yet, but...
All right. Our telethon comes up on November the 25th. We've started preparing. Anybody that can do any events to raise money. This is, the telethon is in aid of Cudeca. As you know, it's the only voluntary cancer care hospice on the coast, or in fact, I think almost in Spain. And we're raising money for another home care team.
And how long have you been running this project?
Well, we've been running it for so long. I mean, it started with putting the roof on the Cudeca building many, many, many years ago. And
well, congratulations. Thank you for being here. For all us expats, can we go in and take a look and meet someone?
I'll show you around.
It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey. It's a brand new day.
Okay, well, Giles is doing their viewpoint program, and they've just put the adverts on, and I'm going to take advantage of the moment to come in. Good morning, Giles. I can't believe I'm back. I'm really, really backstage. Wow. You've met Giles on the program a couple of times, actually, but this is the first time we've actually here in your home. This is really a cool setup.
Welcome to my lair. This is my other job. This is what I do, you know, keeps me off the streets, but welcome to Talk Radio Europe. Good to have you with us in the studio today. You join us live from Viewpoint, which is our current affairs program. We're at the half-time break, so we're going to go live in about 3 minutes' time. Lots of calls in today. We've got studio guests in as well, and it's a busy morning here at Talk Radio Europe.
Oh, well, you could definitely tell he's an official presenter. I mean, it just comes out so word perfect. Is this a change for you? You were doing a different program before. How long has Viewpoint been running with you at the helm?
With me at the helm for about 3 months, but I do other bits and pieces as well in the studio. I've got a Friday afternoon show, I've got a Saturday morning breakfast show, and also a Sunday chill-out show, which is when I really relax and get my weekend finished. Mainly today is a current affairs show. We let people voice their opinions and their views, and it's one of our most popular shows here on Talk Radio Europe.
Well, there you go. If you want to take part, what do you have to do?
Call 952-784-4000 or check us on the studio at talkradioeurope.com or check the website, which is talkradioeurope.com.
You have been in Spain for a long time. How long is a long time?
It's 31 years now on and off, so I get a medal next year. So there you go. But yes, loving it here. And it's great to be able to put something back into the community as we do throughout here. That's the Spanish news just going out now live from our offices in the Costa Blanca. So yes, I'm busy, busy, busy.
Hello.
How are you?
Fine. What are you here talking about today?
We have a list of subjects that, in my case, I didn't get previously. So I'm having to talk ad lib. The subjects are basically topical, and there's some banal subjects and some really heavy duty. We've just done German politics, heavy duty. We did the American terrorist attack, and I think we're going to, as the show moves on, we're going to go to lighter subjects like drinking on aircraft, etc., etc., and people getting pissed in the airport, rightly or wrongly.
Ah, this is what Giles was talking about that vocabulary. Well, thank you very much.
It's my pleasure.
And quickly, before it all starts, back again. Percy, hi, where are you from?
Hi, Nicole. I'm from Marbella, really. I've lived here almost as long as Giles has. But yes, I have a part German background, which obviously was quite helpful discussing the German politics.
And how did you get involved here with Giles coming to the radio? What's your business?
Well, my business is real estate, but I've known Giles for quite a few years.
You go to school together?
No. He cannot claim...
His salvation.
His salvation or mine, I don't
know.
I was
going to say yours, but then that wouldn't be fair.
Well, that was interesting about him saying pissed on air. I thought he was talking about, and then he said craft, so yes. He saved us.
Well, it's lovely to meet you guys. We will let you get back to the program. This is Viewpoint, hosted by Giles Brown. I mean, look at this setup. Absolutely wonderful. And the best thing about Talk Radio Europe is they want you to get involved. So they've got loads of calls in because your view matters. Lads, thank you very much. Okay, so we're going to meet some other presenters. Until now, Giles is our only presenter at Talk Radio Europe. I know there's a few more.
Hey, hey. It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey. It's a brand new day. Halfway twisted. You've been out.
There is so much preparation that goes into every program. Selena McKenzie here has a programme on Talk Radio Europe, and I'm really happy that we've been able to come backstage and actually meet you. I think this is actually the first time we've met. Hello, Selena. I know you're
nice
on Facebook.
Nice to meet you, Nicole. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Know you very well, your voice very well, and then, as I say, from following you on Facebook. But so, Selena, tell us a bit about yourself and your programme.
Okay, I do a programme 1 till 3 called The Lifestyle Show, Monday to Thursday, and also a programme on Sunday mornings, which is a music request show. The Lifestyle Show is very much what it says. It is lifestyles, it's gardening, it's cookery, it's all about people, health, that sort of thing. And I love it. I've been here 5 years and love every minute of it.
What brought you over here?
We came over 10 years ago, actually, and it was the sun. Same as everybody else, it was the sun. We were supposed to move to Portugal, didn't like it as much as here, so came here and really, really enjoy it, yeah.
And your programme, is it an interactive programme? People call in like with some of the other shows here?
Very much so. We do a competition every day where people can win a massive prize of a book, and I get, I'd say, about 20 or 30 calls during the 2 hours of the show, yeah.
I have to say, it's impressive to see the interaction with Talk Radio Europe. It really is the heart of many people's day-to-day. I mean, I'm a big follower myself, but it must be a great satisfaction to know that you're helping these people.
It is. It's incredibly rewarding. And we have a lot of people who say, I'm at home all day on my own, I can't get out, and so we're listening to TRE all day long. And we do like to think, it sounds corny, but we, even people here, we like to think of ourselves as a family, and the listeners are part of that family, so it's really nice.
Wonderful. Well, Selena, thank you very much. I see you are exceedingly busy.
I'm doing call my bluff. I'm trying to work out what a knock-knobbler is, if you can help me.
A knock-knobbler?
A knock-knobbler, yeah.
You'll probably be too late to phone in for that one. But please do tune into Talk Radio Europe, because it really is, it's entertaining. The variety is amazing. Where do you get your ideas from? Just people you meet on the day-to-day?
Yeah, I've got two fantastic producers who help with the interviews. But yeah, we listen to the news, we watch other programmes, and we hear things on the street and think, yeah, that'd be great for the show.
Well, if you've got any ideas for Selena, I'm sure those would be very welcome as well. Hannah was sitting there a second ago and she's gone.
She's in the production studio. Maybe, I don't know if they can go round to the window, or she might be back soon.
Well, if we don't get to see her, give her our love.
We'll do. Definitely will do.
Oh, well, Selena, thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks,
Nicole.
Have a super
day.
You too.
Selena McKenzie.
Hey, hey, it's a brand new day.
Well, it was just a short visit to Talk Radio Europe, but I hope it helped give an idea to what goes on here. So much happening in our wonderful city of Marbella. I've got everybody outside, and I managed to actually catch Hannah, who'd been in the studio doing some production. Is that right?
Yes, I was recording an interview for The Book Show, which goes out on Thursday evenings at 7 o'clock, giving it a little plug, if that's all right, and repeated on Saturdays at 7 as well. So I record the interviews during the week.
Wonderful. There's a lot to fit in, I imagine.
Yes, absolutely. I do the breakfast show live every day from 8 in the morning, but the book show interview is always recorded. And it's so nice to be able to speak to authors from around the world. Some of them are best-selling authors that have sold literally millions of books, and some are first-time local authors, and they all have really different journeys of becoming a published author. And I think it's really interesting to see how they've done it.
It really is interesting. You're a very good interviewer, but I love the way you help us all wake up with a smile in the mornings. I have to say, I'm a big fan of your breakfast show.
Thank you very much. That's good to hear. Yes, I do try and wake people up, so it's nice that it works.
I know that you want to wake people up in another way. You have the telethon coming up in November, but it's not just that day. There's a lot that goes into it, and you need actually prizes because it's a sort of like a raffle auction system.
Yes, it's a very big day. It takes a lot of planning and organisation. There's a lot of us here at TRE and also at Cudeca working really hard to make it a really successful day. We've been running it for many years now at the radio station, and basically throughout the whole day, all of the presenters, we don't do our normal shows, we all come together and take it in turns to spend all day auctioning these items live on air for listeners to phone up and bid so we can raise as much money as possible for Cudeca, which, as you know, is a fantastic charity.
So we need to donate good gifts to make people want to bid.
Exactly. It doesn't matter. I say it doesn't matter what it is. Obviously, the better it is, the more money we can raise. Whether it's celebrity items always go down well. If anyone has any football shirts that have been signed by players, things like that always raise a lot of money, or books signed by authors, things like that are really good. But paintings, silverware, I mean, really anything that people can think of that can raise some really good money for the telethon. If people can get in touch with us, the email address is telethon@talkradioeurope.com. Then as soon as possible, we can be putting these items on the website and people can start bidding. And local restaurants and things like that, they can all be bid for. So
wonderful.
It's all good.
And if you're an artist and you haven't got anything to give, you can create something.
Yes, why not? Yeah. We do. We've auctioned some beautiful paintings and sculptures and things like that in the past.
Wonderful. Well, we have to leave it there for today, but undoubtedly we will be back before the telethon. And if you can help anyway, Talk Radio Europe is your place. Thank you, Hannah.
Thank you so much, Nicole. It's lovely to see you again. And if I could just mention one more tiny little thing, our
Go ahead.
The fail-safe recipe book. We've been collecting recipies from our listeners, recipes where it doesn't. We're looking for desserts particularly at the moment, but any kind of recipe from anywhere around the world. If you email it again to the same email address, telethon@talkradioeurope.com. You may be included in this book, which again we're going to sell to raise as much money for the telethon, TRE, Cudeca telethon. Yes.
Don't they do their job well?
It's like I've said it before.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. It's really been a lot of fun. Talk Radio Europe.
It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey. It's a brand new day.
Halfway twisted, you've been out of shape, and you feel like you've missed it. You dropped out the.
Last week we met Melissa Butler, who's in charge of the American College of Spain. And this week we thought we would come to the American College of Spain and meet the other half, Pancho Campo, who is not just Melissa's husband. There's so much more to this guy. Pancho, hello.
How are you? Good to see you.
It's lovely to be here. You do so many things, Pancho. You started off as a tennis pro?
I used to be a tennis pro. I was not a very good player. I just played in the qualifyings of some big tournament. But then I became a coach, and I traveled the ATP tour, I went to the Olympic Games, and when I decided that I was too much traveling, I opened my own company, Cran Marketing and Events, and through that company, for the last 30 years, you know, we've been putting together some big events with Sting, Pink Floyd, Enrique Iglesias. We brought Al Gore to Spain 3 times, Kofi Annan to Marbella, Francis Ford Coppola. And that's what I've been doing for all my life.
You met Melissa where?
I met Melissa in Dubai. I was still coaching tennis in those days. I had my own tennis academy there. And she was working for her father at the American College of Dubai. And one day we met, and we're still together 20 years later.
You have a beautiful family. Congratulations. They're in a very united family. Count Rudi is very on the program today as well, and is always very emphasis on family. How do you coordinate everything with so much going on with your kids living here on the coast?
Well, that's another aspect of my career. I wrote a book about that, how to keep a balance in your life, because the one thing that I am very proud of, I didn't become rich, or I was not a super tennis star, But as you said, I have a very balanced family. And for me, that's the key word, you know, trying to keep balance. And in my book, I describe balance as a table with four legs, the physical leg, the emotional, the intellectual, and the spiritual. And paying attention to all those four areas on a daily basis, and as soon as you detect that something starting to go wrong or one of the legs starts to shake, you know, you have to fix it. And I guess that's a secret.
Well, you're obviously applying that also here in the American College, sharing that wisdom.
Yeah, well, this is a family project. You know, Melissa's father has been in the business of education, especially universities, for the last 40 or 50 years. And about 4 years ago, she decided to take on the family business. And of course, she said to me, you know, I've been behind you for 18 years. It's your turn to help me out. So here I am, you know, looking after marketing, promotion, events. And what we try here is to provide excellence in education the American way to students from, we have more than 40 different nationalities, mostly Americans, believe it or not, who come to Marbella to train soccer. At the same time, they study under an American university system. So when they go back to their country, they can either go to a better college or have more money in scholarship. And those who really succeed in soccer, they want to have a chance at being scouted and signed by a European team.
Well, there's not like soccer in America. It's funny because it really is such a different level to here in Europe. So that's great news. There's so many reasons to come to Marbella. One of your other passions is wine. You're a connoisseur. And not only do you love it and drink it and talk about it, you have a radio program about it with Talk Radio Europe.
Yeah, I've had that radio program for almost 3 years. I do it just, you know, just for fun. You know, I don't get paid for that. And I'm on a break now. I took a 6 weeks break because, you know, the college starting. I have a tour around Spain for the presentation of my book. And I haven't had a break since we started with the program, as I said, 3 years ago. But yeah, wine has been a passion of mine. And unfortunately, you know, I tend to turn into business all my passions. That's why I have so many hats. But, you know, everything I do, I try to study and become very knowledgeable. You know, I became the first Spanish master of wine in 2008. I studied in Bordeaux, in California, in Austria. And now we're just launching a program which makes me very, very excited. We're doing under the umbrella of the university. It's the Spanish Wine Experience. It's an online program about the wines of Spain. We started this with the Institute of Foreign Commerce of the Ministry of Economy of Spain in 2007. We visited more than 80 cities in 25 countries promoting Spanish wines. But now, you know, I value very much my time with my children. I play tennis with my son 4 or 5 times a week. So I don't want to trouble. So now online is the name of the game. So we have put together an online wine program that is going to be second to none. We're launching October 16 in English, 2 levels, you know, Spanish Wine Experience Level 1, Level 2. And you can follow it from your house, wherever you are. And a lot of people can think, but how can you do a wine course, you know, if you can't taste the wine? Well, that's the secret. We have developed a program that we invite people to buy the wine, wherever they are in the world, and looking at the videos, they can follow me and we can both taste together. So I'm very proud of that program.
This is innovation in progress. Pancho, it's amazing all the hats that you wear, and you wear them all so beautifully. Best of luck with the book tour, and thanks for taking a few minutes to chat with us.
If you allow me 30 seconds, I would like to invite all your viewers. On September the 28th, we have a guest speaker. He was the world's number one junior tennis player, and now he's the president of Fundación AGM Sports. He's coming to talk about how to get a scholarship, sports scholarship or academic scholarship, to study in the United States. Anybody is eligible as long as you have a good academic record or you are good in golf, tennis, soccer, basketball. You can get a scholarship, all expenses paid, to study in a fully accredited American university. You know, that's an opportunity that you can only find in America. So anybody that wants to listen, it's free of charge by invitation. On how you can be eligible for an academic or sports scholarship to an American university, make your way to the American College in Spain next Wednesday, September the 28th, from 5 o'clock onwards.
Sounds like an invitation. We certainly can't refuse. Pancho, thank you so much.
Thanks to you guys. Thank you.
It's a brand new day. Hey, hey, hey. It's a
A lot of people prefer to take their own car when going out at night. However, when it comes to time to go home, that might not be the safest or wisest option. For some, just one glass of wine could put you over the legal limit, which means if you drive, you could put yourself or others at risk, not to mention the controls. So, as we're expats living on the coast, this can be a dilemma, because that's what we do. We go out, we try the wines. And that's why Línea Directa have gone above and beyond with this new completely free bonus policy to people who take out car insurance with them. If you're an expat and live in Malaga, then you get to get all the benefit of this trial of safety first people, a free bonus policy for anyone insuring their car with Línea Directa. But what does this mean? That means that if you find yourself in this dilemma and think possibly you should not be driving, you can just give Línea Directa a call. They will order and pay for a taxi, which will take you and your fellow companions who were with you in the car home with up to a 25 kilometer radius, as long as you all fit in that one taxi and you're all going to the same place. You can even ask for them to pick up your car and take that back too. And this is 7 days a week from midnight to 7 a.m. and up to 4 times a month. And this is obviously all in addition to the fabulous insurance that you get with Línea Directa. Being a Spanish company, they cover you by all the local Spanish laws. Plus, they have a fleet of tow trucks, mechanics, garages, hotels, lawyers, whatever you need. Línea Directa truly do cater to our expats' needs. And all we can say is yes, thank you very much. This is a really nice option to make sure we keep ourselves very safe. If you want more information on this, please go to their website, lineadirector.com, or call them on 952-147834. That's 952-147834, because Línea Directa are putting your safety first.
So you're a business on the Costa del Sol, and you know the best way to reach customers is through word of mouth. But how can you reach more people to grow your business even faster? Before you spend a lot of money on advertising that may never reach your customers, find out how MarbellaFamilyFun.com can help spread the word about your business today. MarbellaFamilyFun.com.
We've come down from the American College of Marbella to the Small World Cafe to meet once again, it's one of those programs getting people coming back in, the lovely Shane O'Shea and also Carlos from Cudeca. We're having kind of a Cudeca day. We talked before about the telethon coming up in November with Talk Radio Europe in aid of Cudeca. But as Shane O'Shea, who organized the Hearts for Arts exhibition at the beginning of the summer, is back in action, and this time funds going to Cudeca. So Carlos, big smile on his face. As always, as he's responsible for getting funds in. Cudeca is the cancer hospice here on the Costa del Sol. Shane, what made you decide to do something for Cudeca with so many things going on? And what are you preparing for this time?
This is even bigger than the last time. Now we're working on a festival from the 2nd to the 8th of October that stretches from Fuengirola to Marbella, with 6 international acts, music acts, coming in for 6 different concerts. And 15% of all our ticket sales go to Cudeca. Over the last number of months, we've developed quite a relationship with Cudeca. We like to be able to support them in any way we possibly can, with any concert, throughout it, promotion, with finance going back to them in whatever way we can. So all our artists are prepared for this. They're coming in from overseas, from New York, which is the one specific for Marbella, in Panorama 187 on the 8th of October. a jazz, international jazz combo, which will be spectacular, are performing for us. So it's six concerts over seven nights. 50% of ticket sales go to Cudeca. Acts never before seen here in Spain, and something like this has never been attempted before in the Costa del Sol. So it's completely new and innovative, and we just can't wait.
It's wonderful. You are very big on bringing people in to see Marbella. So that's very good. You're good. Great promotion for Marbella, apart from bringing new talents to the coast.
Yeah, well, Marbella is just a beautiful spot. I mean, I'm a musician. I've done it all my life. Bringing the acts that I know to Marbella is something I'm very proud of. It's bringing something new here. The cultures here, the diaspora, the number of people from all over the world that live in Marbella, they just soak up this kind of thing. They love it and want more of it. So we are attempting to bring more to this area, not just Marbella, but up and down the coast. And for us to be successful, we just want you to come to these concerts.
So for us in Marbella, we're getting jazz from New York. What are the other areas getting? What are the other evenings?
Oh, some crazy stuff. We have an amazing countertenor. His name is Kang Nang Justin Kim. He's from America, but he's recently worked with Placido Domingo in Mexico. He's unbelievable. He's booked up in every decent opera house across Europe. We have a trio, piano trio, coming in from Australia. Also unbelievable. We have Jacob Shaw, a cellist who's played here a couple of times before. He's based in Denmark and Copenhagen, so he's playing in the Danish church. We have a wonderful new French group called Les Temps Modernes coming from France and performing a piece that I believe may not have been performed in Spain ever before, a piece by Messiaen called Quartet for the End of Time, which is a stalwart, massive piece for the 20th century in the classical genre. So we're looking forward to the diversity every night, different groups, different... there's something there for everybody. I hope some people will come to all six and then they can sit back and go, there's a cultural overdose, can't wait for next year. It's going to be an annual event. This is not a one-off, and we expand next year to 2 weeks, 14 nights hopefully of concerts, and we leave it at that, bring in music, dance, art, more culture from around Spain and Andalusia, and build it to a point of it being completely unique, not just in Spain, but a festival of its sort anywhere in Europe.
It really sounds wonderful. I know there's a lot of work involved. You're bringing the artists in. It sounds fabulous, but the prices, the same caliber. What kind of ticket price are we looking at?
Tickets range from €8 to €12. So we are keeping it affordable. We want to engage the local community, as well as the expats that are here, and maybe some holidaymakers that sometimes don't go to these events when they're here for a week. They're not going to go to a classical music concert, may not. So we've kept it affordable. We're not in here to make thousands and thousands and thousands. You do not make money on arts festivals. It's plain and simple. If you break even, you're tremendously lucky. And especially as this is our first one, if we break even, we will celebrate for a week.
Well, I hope you do, and I hope you raise lots of money for Cudeca. And I always think it's wonderful with Carlos, because he's in charge of raising funds for Cudeca, and you have so many people helping you. You must feel quite blessed that people help make your life so much easier by organising events all over the place for Cudeca.
It is, yeah. I mean, first of all, I'd like to thank Shane. You know, he's a great person above all, and he's doing some great... we like to organise quirky events, different events. We don't want people to think, here comes another Cudeca event, another dinner dance. This is far from that. This is so unique that that's what grabbed me, first of all, when Shane mentioned it to me. It's so unique. There's so many different concerts. There's so many things that go along on the coast here that are samey, and this is so much different. There's so much is going to get the public's imagination. And I just thank Shane for letting us be part of it. It's lovely. We've got to have Cudeca representatives there. And it's going to be great to be a part of. And it's nice to be there at the initiation of this. And then we can go on from this.
This is your Cudeca emblem signal.
I'm going to have to correct you there. It's actually the worldwide palliative care sunflower. Sorry, you weren't to know that. But Cudeca's...
I'm lucky I don't know that.
Exactly, you are in a way. You are in a way, yes. Well said. You know, that's why, obviously, what our line of work is, that's why even more we want to do events like this to, you know, it's all going towards... what is the, you know, palliative care at the end of the day. But we like to do fun events. Joan Hunt, the owner of Cudeca, said to me, Carlos, when I started this new role, put the fun into fundraising. I think I told you before. And Shane is helping us do that.
Well, unfortunately, I mean, there are so many different charities and everybody does need help and everybody needs our money. And with something like cancer, until it actually touches you, it's very hard to identify with what it entails before, during, after.
It is, yeah. It's it is unique, unless it's happened to you or a family member or something you really don't know, which is why that people, I find it extra when people that haven't been touched by it still find, you know, the morals and everything to come along to these events and to support us, because it's easy when it's happened to you, it's easy to say, right, okay, it's happened to me, so I'm going to help somebody else. But I find it's an extra thing when people haven't been touched by it and they're still thinking, I could be in that position.
Exactly. Well, Carlos from Cudeca, the lovely Sean O'Shea, who's helping raise money and also bringing us a fabulous touch of culture. And those of us who are lucky that we haven't been touched by such a terrible illness as cancer closely in our family, as Carlos is saying, even more reason perhaps for us to go along and support these events. I've got shivers. Oh, so nice to be with people who care. Shane, best of luck.
Thank you.
And the same to you, Carlos. Thank you.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Hey, hey, it's a brand new day. Hey, 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 it's a brand new day.
We have so many talented people who live in Marbella or visit Marbella and call Marbella home at least part of the year. One of those is Emmanuel Lehman. He is a Swiss Spaniard who sings and composes in 5 different languages, and he just got married to the lovely Laura Martini baby Arranz. From Marbella Now, we want to say congratulations. You're an amazing couple. And to pay tribute to both of you and your amazing family, we're going to play Emmanuel's video, Una Isla. I hope you love it as much as I do.
Una Isla me llevaría mis discos de jazz y mis libros de espías. Cartas de amor y tu fotografía. Ahí una sirena me hará compañía. Mi jarra de vino, mi horóscopo chino, la punta de lanza contra el enemigo. Mi punto, mi coma, mi entre comillas. A una isla desierta yo me llevaría. El tiempo dirá, tal vez tú seas mi isla en medio del mar. Hacia ti me llevará. Doy vueltas como una espiral. A una isla y me llevaría mis juegos de azar y mis noches de timba. Las rimas secretas de mi poesía, que tú sin saberlo yo te escribía. Sombreros de pico, mi sexto sentido. Soldados de plomo de cuando era crío. Con faltas de ortografía, a una isla desierta yo me llevaría. El tiempo dirá, tal vez tú seas mi isla en medio del mar. El viento hacia ti me llevará. Doy vueltas con una espiral. We'll be right back.
this next section is sponsored by Línea Directa, tailored-made expat car insurance. We've had a lot of people asking us why they are getting phone numbers charged onto their phone bills when apparently they have a flat rate. Well, there is a flat rate that you get normally with your landline and your mobile phones that come with all the different packages. But the 900 numbers and the 902s and the 905s, well, that's a different story. And you really need to see individually, according to who your service provider is, what these charges entail. When you use a landline number, for example, if it begins with 91, we know it's from Madrid. 93 is Barcelona, and typically for Marbella is 952 and 951. But the numbers that start with 900, as I say, are different, and these are charged separately unless you have an agreement with your service provider to cover these calls as well, which most expats don't even know about, which is why we're talking about it today. 900 numbers are typically a free phone call if you're ringing from a landline, but depending on your mobile service provider, whether it's free or not. 901 numbers are numbers that the cost of the call is shared between the person calling and the person receiving the call. But the 902 numbers are the calls that the person dialing is responsible for in its entirety. Now, these calls are a little bit more expensive, perhaps, but if you don't have an agreement for a 902 number, and these are typically numbers used for people giving us for a service department, you could be on the phone for 5, 10, 15 minutes or more, and some of these calls can be very, very expensive. So please, if you have a local phone number, a phone that you've taken out in Spain while you're here on holiday or you're living here, when you make your contract, you really need to be careful to make sure you have the extra agreements to cover these 900s, 901s and 902 numbers. Now, 905 numbers are really expensive, and it seems that lately people are dialing these numbers, leaving lost calls, so you ring them back. And as they can be up to four or more than €4 a minute, please be careful, because these scams do go on and you need to be aware. Germany has been the subject of the last few programmes because on the 3rd of October we were celebrating the Día de Alemania, the day of unification of East and West Germany, which is obviously a very important date, one I remember watching, one of those significant dates. But today, very lucky to have with us again on the programme Count Rudi and Princess Mary Louise, but not to talk about that specifically. But did you know Count Rudi was the president of the German school here for some 15 years and just resigned? Good morning, Count.
Good morning. Then, part of being at the Marbella Club since 60 years, and have been 15 years at the honor to be president of the German school. German school is meanwhile one of the most important foreign schools here on the coast, and particularly one of the three best German foreign schools in the world, which I'm very proud to say, which we achieved during these 15 years and the years before. It's not only a lovely education, but it is a wonderful mixture of nationalities. It is a very European school, because we do not want only to teach Germans, but we want them, all the Spaniards, the foreigners who are here, all to come and profit of the knowledge which we can pass on to them.
You just recently had a lot of Americans brought into the school sharing your format, the way that things are done, spreading the word that you're talking about.
Of course, we have all, every year we do quite a lot of things which is not 100% school, but which is their teaching and academic development, but which is other things for the pupils to bring them up again, as I said, to good Europeans, to international feeling. So to have, for example, that we had 8 years ago and this year again, a great play organized by an American group called Young Americans. And the Young Americans taught during 1 week 500 pupils from the German school to act in a show which was finally held last Saturday in the bullring of Estepona. You know, the joy of having so many different nationalities united in German school. We have 27 nationalities who do study there, and all finishing up their baccalaureate, and fortunately all or nearly all make it every year well. We want them not only to take all the lovely things which history can teach them about this country, about Germany, about the world in general, but we want them also to be prepared to be good citizens in their future positions, that when they come out of school, that they're not just lost, but not only that they speak 3 to 4 languages fluently, but also that they know how to behave, how to be a gentleman, how to present themselves to the future boss where they try to get a position in the company or thing. So, you know, it's very important that you know that you teach those children how they should come in. If they come in for an interview to the manager of that company, and that they know how to open, how to greet, not to go straight away with him to the hand like this, but to wait that the manager invites them, sit down or something. You know, all these things which a young boy or a young girl don't know. So how should they? How should they know it? And so we try to have always at the end of every year, during 1 week, we have also sessions to have good behavior, good things, and good lessons for the future. This is what the boys and girls need to, when they come into the world, that they are not just coming from little Marbella, where it's just a beautiful, world-famous town, but that they also know how to behave and to make a good picture of Marbella in the world.
Well, it's a fabulous goal, and I think that you've, as you say, have started at the 60s here with the Marbella Club, but you've been an integral part of the growth of Marbella, and today, 127 nationalities registered on our 10 census. We have a mini world peace, and a lot to do with that is the education and that benefit of all the different nationalities sharing what we know. On the other side here, we have behind every great man, there's a great woman, and vice versa, a perfect team. Princess Marie Louise is obviously Count Rudi's wife and a big supporter, and a big supporter of our community. And following in her footsteps of Princess Diana, we heard last time we chatted, Princess Marie Louise is a big supporter of Concordia, which is the charity raising money for AIDS victims, families and awareness. Well done on your summer gala, Princess Marie Louise.
Thank you very much. I think the people enjoyed it. It was a lovely theme, Asia, so we could decorate everything. We could give food. The people who danced, they came from London and they wear ties. So they came with all these lovely dresses, and so it was a big success. And in Olivia, it really goes so well in this patio in the palace of Babylonia. So it was really, thanks God, it was a big success.
You raised some €70,000 from that event.
Yes, more or less, yes, exactly.
Does that go a long way, or is it just a drop in the ocean?
Well, it's a quite big drop, but we still need some more because we have a lot of expenses only for these 5 people working for us, and the cars driving up and down the coast, and so it's quite a lot of money we need to get on working here and not to have to cut down. So I hope that the summer gala has gone, the follow-up is done. So there we are again now to organize the Nicholas Gala. So I hope that lots of people this time will come. It's not so expensive than the summer gala. It's €180 for each, and cocktails and dinner and show and dancing, everything. And also, Nicole, I'm looking for a sponsor, because that's really important. In the summer gala we didn't find any, so of course I would have more money if we had found one, but perhaps for 10,000 we can find somebody who will be the big star at the St. Nicholas Gala. So perhaps you find somebody for me, or if there's somebody interested, that they get in contact with me. It's this time, the 25th of November, because there is such a big puente that everybody will leave Marbella, and so we decided to do it already on the 25th of November.
Do Did you manage to get any Spanish or English table at the summer gala in the end?
English table, I'm very sorry, I didn't.
So we really need Spanish, to get ourselves together for this one, because we're getting ourselves a bad name here about not being involved. But it's maybe a higher price ticket, but it is such a worthy cause that other people seem to ignore. AIDS is a very delicate subject.
It is, and I understand that the people prefer to give it to children or animals or old people, but we have this problem here. And there are people who really, they didn't look for it. So we really have to help them, especially to go to the schools and give lectures and to that they really know how not to get AIDS. I think that's very important. And we go to all the schools. And now thanks to you also to the first English school, they invited us to come. So we are very happy. And yes, it's very important that you help us, because we get more and more young people now with AIDS, and it's there and it's between us. Nobody talks about it anymore, but we have AIDS everywhere and here too. So please come and do the test, the quick test, to be sure if you have the virus in your body or not. And we do that in San Pedro, in our place, or in Estepona. Also in Micha's Costa.
Well, as Princess Mary was saying, I don't know why we seem to associate AIDS with either drug use or things that it doesn't touch or affect us, but it's completely the opposite. And it's very important, as Marie-Louise says, that we get the children involved, that they know what it's about. Big thank you to Laudi International School, not only for inviting the Princesses Association to talk, but we have confirmed that on Tuesday, the 25th of April, we will be holding our next United Nationalities of MarbellaNOW Summit, and hopefully the princess can come. I have to look on a calendar, but to address the children herself, because it really does make a difference to show that everyone can get involved in these very worthy causes. Princess Marie-Louise, thank you very much. Hopefully you can come back before the St. Nicholas event to talk again about the subject. Yes, Count Rudi, you've resigned now from the German school. What are you going to do with all that time?
Exactly. There's never enough time for all what I want to do, because I'm still completely active at the Marbella Club, and I'm very happy to be there between Marbella Club and Puente Romano there. So there's plenty to do there and many other things which pays for me. But that's why I'm so happy that I have a chance also to speak of this, of the hotel, because at Puente Romano, where we have always this San Nicolas Gala, because in summer we can have the galas outdoors, which is typically Marbella, that's why we have them at the end of July. But once it gets cold at night, people don't want to sit outdoors. So at Puente Romano, we have a lovely big room, party room, where we can seat up to 400 people, and 354, but still, and it brings you into the wonderful pre-Christmas atmosphere. Many people don't know what they should do there with St. Nicholas. They heard of it. They heard the deformation of Santa Claus, which is completely concerning Christmas. But St. Nicholas was a very good bishop, which gave this name to Santa Claus, but to help to the poor ones and to the one who needed help. Typical for Concordia. But it has even more, that it gives this family life. The pre-Christmas time is so beautiful because you have the chance to get together at home. Our days, we all suffer that we have so little time to spend with our families at home. The pre-Christmas time is prepared for such thing. You start decorating the home, you start having this nice atmosphere, gets earlier dark, you have some candles on, you have maybe some cookies prepared already in view for Christmas, which you serve already, or you have some lovely wine which you do drink and everything. So they better don't give them this first feeling, which is so nice, and I'm so happy that the people hear already now of it. It's on the November 25th. It will take place at Puente Romano. You heard already, it costs only €180 for this good event, for a delicious dinner, lovely cocktails before, bell entertaining, because a part of St. Nicholas who comes with all the presents, you get tremendous presents, so good before Christmas, You have to pay for them, of course, also that's like a raffle. But you have these things, so well done. So I really can only encourage you, go and come. It's for me one of the best evenings I have every year in Marbella.
Well, thank you very much. As you can see, what a perfect couple. What a perfect partner. As I said, behind every great man is a great woman, and every great woman has his great man. Humility personified, Princess Marie-Louise, Count Rudi, thank you very much. These amazing paintings, saucy paintings, behind me are the amazing talents of Debbie Lush here. Hello, Debbie. Your name is so perfect for your artwork.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me on the show today.
Oh, it's my pleasure. I met Debbie, you see, it's a small community, through Lawrence Dillimore. He is a reporter for the Olive Press, a great local newspaper for us expats. And we met, when did we first meet?
Gosh, it was a few months ago, Nicole.
I don't want parties, some event.
Yeah, and it all led through the Lawrence's newspaper and my paintings, and here we are today.
Yes, Lawrence and Debbie are neighbours, both newbies relatively to Marbella. Have you been helping each other out?
Yes, but I do need to learn some Spanish.
We've just been talking about that great Spanish course there are going on. Very, very reasonable. So do check out learning the language if you're going to be living here.
I will.
Well, first of all, thank you for bringing your talent to Marbella.
Thank
you. Are
you
so perfect for this. It seems very fashion inspired. Mm. What is, you love shoes, I know that.
It is. Basically, I started painting many moons ago in inspired by shoes and the program Sex in the City with Carrie Bradshaw. I don't know if you know that character, but she was just obsessed with designer shoes, Manolo Blahnik and Christian Louboutin shoes. And I wondered what would it be like to paint these, because I wanted to be different and nobody else was really doing them at the time. So I started painting the shoes like these ones here. And it all led from there, and people started buying them, and it was wedding presents and 50th birthday presents and 21st. But I've always liked to paint females and fashion and things like that. So that's how I got started.
Were you like a great student for art at school? I mean, when did it actually blossom, this talent?
Oh gosh, I've been painting since I was very, very young child. Always drawing, painting. I have a background in interior design. After I left school, I did an interior design course, which was based on architectural drawings, and I was always using perspective drawing and drawing. I worked in architecture as well, but my love is really oil paints and paintings.
What made you choose Marbella?
Oh wow. I've been coming to Spain for a number of years, and I feel it's such a fabulous place. It's so cosmopolitan. It's very different. There's people from all over the world. Of course, the climate, it's a very beautiful place. Ireland is too cold for me. It's just too cold. That's my native country. And I felt there was huge opportunity to broaden my horizons with my art career in Marbella.
Well, I think you're 100% spot on. You've just signed up to do an exhibition in a gallery here.
Yes, I'm now working with the Atrium Gallery in Marbella. So they have a few of my paintings at the moment in a group show, and they're really good. They're really
something like this. About 9,000 euros?
Yes, but I mean, there are less expensive pieces as well. This is from the 50 Shades of Marbella collection, these two pieces, which was inspired by the 50 Shades books and film. I decided it would be an interesting subject to paint females in different positions. And it's really about empowering women, although it may not seem that at first. It's about exploring the feelings of submission, domination, love, trust, honesty, and a lot of respect, actually, in this collection. So there's a lot of emotions behind the paintings that you see here today.
Well, I love the variety, but they always have that same look, the Debbie Lush look. You have a Debbie Lush look book.
Yes, I do. It's a contemporary book just of a variety of paintings that I do. I do portraits, still life, seascapes. So I do a variety of paintings. So this is just a small sample that we see here today.
So we can go and visit you at the Atrium.
Atrium Gallery.
Atrium Gallery.
Or you can look on my website as well for updates, which is www.dlushdesigns.ie.
For Ireland?
Yes, IE for Ireland.
IE, a great artist. Debbie, thank you so much.
Thank
and
you,
best
Nicole.
Of luck.
Thank you.
It's a brand new day.
Well, that's it for another week. Thank you so much for joining us on our little tour around Marbella. A big thank you to the Small World Cafe right underneath the American College of Spain for welcoming us in, a perfect place to interview our international community. Take care, be nice to each other, and we'll see you, hopefully, next week.
You've been out of shape and you feel like you've missed it. You dropped out the